Hey guys and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today is our day 26 and today we are going to learn about packages and pip command. So packages basically contains multiple modules or Python files. Packages are created by developers for making it easy for us to use the methods and classes, which will take very long to develop manually. And we simply need to download those packages and we can directly use them in our programs. So we can download these packages with using pip command. So pip command. Pip is the command which we use for managing our Python packages. We use these commands a lot, like install to install a specific package, uninstall to uninstall a specific package or to remove a specific package, list to show or to get the list of all the installed packages on your current environment, on your current system. So these three are the most important commands which we use a lot. So without any ado, let's get started and let's start with packages.
Hey guys, so we are back with our computer and today we are going to discuss a very important and a very interesting topic, which is pip command. Okay, so basically packages. So what are packages in Python? So in Python there are multiple packages which we can use. So what is a package? So multiple modules, okay, when multiple modules are combined we get a package. You can say a package contains multiple modules. That's what a package is. Okay, so why these packages are made? So if I want to write some complex mathematics code, then I won't write all that code manually. What I will do is I will take help of math package and then I can use all those methods in those modules inside of that math package. So math in that math module you can see multiple methods like square root, like there are multiple methods like for trigonometric functions you have sine, cos, tan and all those different functions for that. So you can just simply use that, you can simply import that and you can start using it. So that's what we are going to learn today. So first of all, open your Visual Studio Code. Here I have this clean project. So now let me create a file. Let us say main.py. So we have this file now. Okay, so here how we import any modules or any packages. So for that what we do is we say to import a specific method, we do from specific module import method, right? So from specific module we import a specific method like this. And if I want to import the whole module, we do like this, we import this module directly. So now let us see how we can download these packages. Okay, so let us open our browser first of all, and here you can head over to PyPI. You can see this, the Python package indexing. You can head over to this website and here you can see you have this window. You can browse projects and you can do whatever you want. So now let us have a look over Wikipedia package we have in this Python. So here you can see I have searched for Wikipedia PyPI and here you have this link Wikipedia, which is the name of package. And here you can see Wikipedia is the Python library that makes it easy to access and parse data from Wikipedia. So that's what the functionality of this Wikipedia package is. So what we are going to do is, here you have this documentation, you can say here you have this link. Okay, so here you have these things which you can do with this package. You have in the installation part how you can install it. So for that let me open my command prompt here. And now let's open it. Now here type this pip command. Okay, and then you should see text like this. You should see this commands and this usage. Okay, so you should see this type of output here. Okay, if you don't see this output, then there is some mistake in your installation. There is some mistake during the installation process. So what you can do is you can watch the videos over YouTube. There is one YouTuber, Code with Harry, who is who showed that how you can install the Python and how you can solve that specific error if you get error that pip is not recognized as internal or external command. So you can follow Code with Harry as well. He is a very good programmer and YouTuber. So here you have this output. Here we have this output. So if you get this output, then we will head over to our next part. Okay, so let me clear this terminal with using CLS. You can clear your terminal in Windows, and with using clear you can clear your terminal in Linux or those Unix based operating systems. Okay, so now let us type pip list. Okay, so with this command you can see all those packages which are currently installed in your system. Okay, so these are the packages which are installed in your system. Currently I have this Wikipedia here. I have this Wikipedia 1.4.0. so you will not see this because it is not installed. It doesn't come installed by default. So what we are going to do is we are going to install this package. So let me delete this package first. Okay, so you can delete this package. You can say, and for now simply ignore this warning. I will show how to clear that warning later. So what we are going to do is we are going to search pip uninstall and the name of package, which we have Wikipedia, right? So let me run this command. Here it is asking me that yes or no. It is asking me for permission to proceed or not. So I'm providing yes, and here you can see successfully uninstalled Wikipedia. So with using this command pip uninstall the name of package. What is pip? Pip is the command, just like npm and all those. If you have some idea with Node.js, then you may know this. So pip is basically package manager. Okay, package management for your Python. Okay, so we have uninstalled our Wikipedia. Now to install it, we will use pip install and the name of package. So I want Wikipedia, right? I want Wikipedia. So here you can see we have downloaded this. You can see successfully installed Wikipedia 1.4.0. okay, now let me clear this terminal. Okay, so here now let us run our pip list again. Now currently we have version 1.4.0 installed in our computer, right? We have Wikipedia package version 1.4.0. and on our documentation, if you will see here in release history, you can find all those versions which you have. So if I want to use this 1.3.0 in my project for some case, okay, or for some reason, then what I can do is I can install that specific version of Wikipedia. So for that I need to clear this. First of all, let me uninstall it. So pip uninstall Wikipedia. Now we are uninstalling our Wikipedia module. So let me clear it and let me run pip list. So now here you can see our Wikipedia is now removed. Now to install our Wikipedia version 1.3.0, what we will do is we will simply say pip install Wikipedia is equal to 3.0. okay, if I want to use the specific version. If I want to use 1.3. the latest version, I can use star here. If I want to use 1.3, if I will provide nothing, it will definitely download, it will definitely install the latest version. Okay, so 1.3. the latest version of that specific package. Okay, not the latest, but 1.3. Let's say 5 is the highest version, so it will download 1.3.5. But currently we don't need anything like that. We just need to install version 1.4.0. We can install it like this or without doing like this. It will this pip install will basically install the latest package for you. So we have installed our Wikipedia 1.4.0. Now what we need is, let me clear this terminal and let us check pip list again and let us have a look to that warning. So here you can see we have warning, you are using pip version 21.2.3, however version 21.2.4 is available. You should consider upgrading via this command. And now what we are going to do, let me copy this command up to here. Okay, you can directly copy this command and you can paste it, but let me tell you the command. So we have this command. Now what you have to do is simply write Python. Okay, because Python is now the command which we can use. So python-m pip install and all this command, if we'll run it, you can see we are downloading this pip version 21.2.4 and we are uninstalling this 21.2.3. So we have uninstalled this 21.2.3 and then we have installed 21.2.4. Now let us clear it and now let us have a look at that specific warning. So now the warning is disappeared. Okay, so here you can see our package is also installed. Now how we can use it in our programs? We can simply do one thing, we can simply import these packages. We can do import Wikipedia directly and then we can print, let's say Wikipedia dot summary. There is one method, summary, and what this method will do is it will give us the summary of that specific search. So let us search for computer programming. Let us search it. Now let us run our code. So now you can see this result. Computer programming is the process of designing and building. Okay, so here you can see our output. We have this summary from our specific search. So we have the summary of this specific computer programming Wikipedia search. So we can use this summary like this, but what we can do instead of using this, we can simply import our summary and from Wikipedia. Now we don't need this Wikipedia dot here, and now we have this type of code. And now if you will run it, you can see we have the same output as before. So we can use these functions from our Wikipedia package like this. And to have a look at all of those packages, what you can do is you can head over to the specific documentation of that project. Okay, so what you can do is you can simply search for Python Wikipedia documentation. Here you can see Wikipedia document 0.9 documentation. Simply go over here and here you can see this basic documentation and quick start. Okay, so Wikipedia documentation, simply click on this link and here you can see all those functions and classes you have, exceptions that are there. So summary, you can see we have wikipedia.summary which will get Wikipedia search suggestions for query. Okay, return string, if none, no suggestion was found, it will return that. Okay, so this is suggest, basically this is summary. Then we have page, we have geo search, we have, there are multiple things you can see. We have this parent ID, references, then we have section, we have summary again, So this is plain text of summary. This is basically this is not a function, it is the property which it has. So now let's search about computer. Search here, you can see computer hardware. We have this list of the objects. So basically you can use multiple methods from this Wikipedia package. Now so we learned how to install packages, how to install a specific version, how to uninstall packages, how to check the list of packages that we have on our computer, and we have learned a lot about these packages and pip command. So now we have successfully completed our today's video again. So thank you for watching this video, guys, and I will see you in the next video.